Igor, let me ask you this straight away. You look like a different goaltender to me this year. You were really good here last year, but you look so much more confident. What's the difference between you this year and last year?
Obviously, I get a lot of experience playing a lot of games last year, and coming into this year during the preseason, work a lot with the goalie coaches. As a big guy, for me, moving too much is bad. However, my goal is not sound, but pretty much trying to calm down, move as less as possible, sometimes even save the energy, because it's sometimes it's a long game, even over times. So yeah, pretty much that's it. And obviously, as you get more experience, you kind of know in the game, know what the players do.
But you talk about moving too much as a big man. There's no question, to my eyes anyway, that you look like a guy who's more composed over your skates. You're never flailing, you're not throwing yourself around. How much have you worked on body control and composure?
That was one of the main goals, obviously, because last year I had trouble with this sliding too much, especially on my butterfly, and work a lot. Now game is inventing the new style a little bit, so especially stopping on a post with a goalie skate. So using that a lot and just trying to cover as much as possible being square, that's pretty much it.
Well, and I got to believe that helps with your rebound control as well, which is much better this year, which you would, I guess, expect with all that experience, right?
Yeah, I guess.
But it is better this year, I think. And I think
not this game, not the last game.
Well, of course, but see, and I say that, and Igor, of course, is going to tell me I'm wrong because you're not perfect, but you are a perfectionist. And I remember talking to you last year in shoot and skates and after games, you knew exactly how many goals you gave up in shoot around or in morning skate, rather, excuse me. That matters to you. You don't like giving up a goal ever.
Oh, nobody likes to give up a goal ever. I would love to get a shout out even though I practice.
Yeah, of course. But, you know, I think one of the things everybody knows about you is that you spent some time in Anaheim this year. You've played a lot in the AHL. How much does that experience of just being around the NHL game and playing in the AHL, how much does that help you?
Obviously, NHL, it's no doubt best league in the world, and you're seeing how your partners prepare, how hard they work to get there, and obviously how hard you have to still work to stay there. And you just learn from them, especially like watching the goalies play, obviously, again, like watching the best goaltender in the world, like Tuukka Rask, Carey Price, you look at the that seems like they're doing much, honestly. They're just in position all the time. They're so good at it. So pretty much that's probably one of the biggest things.
I got to imagine that drives you, though, because I know as competitive as you are, you know that you're going to be there. I imagine you believe in yourself that you can play at that level.
Oh, obviously, I believe in myself. I never stop. I have my goal, and I'm going to it.
And the last thing I'll ask you is talk about the Utah Grizzlies and talk about this experience. This has become a second home to you. The fans love you. You're one of the fan favorites. How comfortable are you in the Maverick Center and playing for the Utah Grizzlies?
Honestly, I love Mavericks. Maverick Center, one of the best places to play hockey. Every time we're playing here, I enjoy it. Fans are great. It's loud. It's fun to play in front of them. Really appreciate that. And obviously the team, great group of guys, love them. And we just going into every game to battle and win the games.
Hey, it's always good to see you. Stay healthy. Thanks for being here, man.
Thank you very much.
That's Igor Bobkov. More Utah Grizzlies hockey straight ahead on My Utah TV.